Dhritarashtra to enlighten us by his knowledge. Before that, I would like to request Srimati Maheshwari GB ma'am to introduce Dr. Irvin Nawale sir for the active crowd.
Thank you, Riya Supriya. Good evening, everyone. I'm Maheshwari. It's my great privilege to introduce today's speaker, Dr. Irvin M. Nawale. Dr. Irvin M. Nawale is working as head Department of English in Shivaji Mahavidyalaya, Udgir, Latur District, Maharashtra. He has been teaching English language and literature since last 23 years. Mr. Nawale has authored, co-authored, translated, and co-edited several books. He has presented and published 24 papers and 44 journal papers, book chapters. He has delivered 50 talks and conducted 9 literary interviews. Sir also has 5 forwards, books review to his credit. More than 30 books of his are subscribed across the globe, like USA, UK, South Africa, Australia, Germany, Canada, France, etc. He has also worked on various bodies and committees of different universities, including member of the Senate Faculty of Arts and BOS in English of SRTM University, Nanded. He is also working on the editorial, advisory, review board of more than a dozen prestigious international journals. He has successfully organized many events, including one university-sponsored workshop, one NAC-sponsored national conference, and one university-sponsored international web conference as convener. He has completed one MRP under financial assistance of UGC. Now, our renowned speaker is going to deliver a talk on multidisciplinary research methodology, artificial intelligence. I extend a warm welcome to you, sir, for today's webinar. I thank Siddhamangala Seva Kendra, Vachana Samaja, and All India Research Association for providing an opportunity to introduce today's speaker. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Maheshwari ma'am. Dr. Irvin Nawale, sir, we are eagerly waiting for your words, sir. Please go ahead, sir. Sir, you're on mute, sir.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
The organizing authorities of this pan-global Pondian Banquet of Knowledge International webinar on multidisciplinary research, organized by SMSK Bangalore in collaboration with All India Researchers Association Mysore and Vachak Samaj Indo-European Cultural Committee Poland, Honorable Dr. Sheila Devi Ji Malimat, the program director and the coordinator of this international event, Sri Shukumar Sekhar, founder Vachak Samaj Indo-European Cultural Committee Poland, Honorable Professor Dr. Prabhu Dev Ji, the inaugural guest, who has delivered such a knowledge boosting, inspiring, motivating, and fantastic inaugural speech. Just my co-panelist, Honorable Hek Anshuji Rostogi from Poland. My another co-panelist, Om Prakash Ji, the President, Secretary, and members of SMSK Bangalore. This event is organized for the research scholars and research supervisor. Approximately 350 participants are visible here. And those who are viewing us, watching us through YouTube Live. A very good evening to one and all. There is a connection. There is a correction in the topic. The topic said by the anchor was not allotted to me. The topic allocated to me is the importance of research methodology and style set and view of literature in doctoral research. And I am here to talk on it. Before proceeding to main topic, let us see what exactly research is. Any research can be defined traditionally as gathering data that can help to answer the questions about various aspects in the concerned subject. It is a logical and systematic search for new and useful information on a particular topic. It is an investigation of findings, solution to scientific, social, or literary problems through objectives and systematic analysis. It is a discovery of hidden or probably acceptable truths. It should lead to a new contribution to the existing knowledge, and it must be done with the help of study, experiment, observation, analysis, comparison, and reasoning leading to the findings. Research is a careful, systematic, and patient investigation in any field of knowledge undertaken to establish facts or principles. It is a structured inquiry and utilizes an acceptable specific methodology to collect, analyze, and interpret information to solve problems or answer questions and to create any knowledge that is generally applicable. It can therefore simply be described as a journey embarked upon that leads to the discovery of new knowledge or revision of facts, theories, and applications. Thus, any research conducted must make an original contribution to the existing body of the knowledge in the relevant discipline. Research is not confined to science and technology only. There are vast areas of research in other disciplines, such as language, literature, social sciences, and so on. Whatever might be the subject, research has to be an active, industrious, and systematic process of inquiry in order to discover, interpret, or revise facts, events, behaviors, and theories, applying the outcome of research for the refinement of knowledge in subject or discipline. The research methodology is the strategy of investigation of select topic from the beginning to the end, including how the research objective have been found and formed from the research problem, how the literary review, the pilot study, data collection, analytical methods, and the process of developing findings and conclusions have been carried out. It is therefore a range of various issues that are strategies of inquiry, theoretical or the secondary and primary data collection, sampling issues, primary data collection, design of questionnaires, data collection and analyzing procedure, data presentation and discussion, and above all, validation of research findings. In the social sciences, there are three research methodologies that can be used to conduct academic research. These are the first, quantitative research methodology, which is also known as the traditional positivist or the empiristic research approach. Second, qualitative research methodology, which is variously referred to as constructivist, naturalistic, interpretive, post-positive, or postmodern perspective or the approach to the research. And the last, that is third, mixed methodology or the multi-methodology or the pragmatic approach. It is an amalgam of quantitative and qualitative research methodologies in one study. It can be described as the matrix of theoretical mindsets that underpin research using research tools and applying principles and procedures of logical thought processes to an investigation to achieve aims and objectives of the research. In academic research, how you present your information technically is often seen as important as the ideas you are putting forth. Proper citing, quoting, and referencing of source material allows you to convey your range of research in a language commonly shared by others in your discipline. Giving others a chance to review and compare your work under these established guidelines enables your instructors as well as readers to better see the work on its own merits, opposed to getting sidetracked by technical inefficiencies. Writing a good doctoral dissertation is, in and of itself, a major intellectual challenge. Having to follow detailed citation and formatting guidelines, as well, many seem like just one more task to add to an already too long list requirements. The research methodology must be supplemented with proper style sheets for the documentations of parenthetical citations, endnotes, footnotes, select bibliography, and formatting styles. Following the guidelines of style sheets serve several important purposes. It shows that you respect other people's work enough to give them proper credit for it. It also helps your reader find additional materials if he or she wishes to learn more about your topic. It helps you to adhere with academic ethics. It is the literary equivalent of wearing a tailored suit to a job interview. Documentations and organizations are important factors in thesis writing as they are critical components of constructing a well-crafted research. The different styling guides help to keep the body of the writers and additional information organized in a presentable manner. You must know how and where to put the tables, videos, charts, or diagrams needed or format the image or cite the website, video talk that will help the audience catch the topic itself. The style adds the standard measures to your research work. The big themes of such style sheets are APA, MLA, and CMS. These three main schools of style used to properly formatting your research under different disciplines. The first, APA style, is a citation protocol established by the American Psychological Association. This style was developed to ensure consistency and provide style rules for scientific writing. API is the most often used in the discipline of social sciences, including psychology, education, sociology, economic, criminal justice, and so on. It is also even used in the business, etc. The second style sheet, that is MLA style, is a citation protocol established by the Modern Language Association. MLA is most often used in the humanities disciplines, including English language and literature, comparative literature, ELT, cultural studies, foreign languages, and other areas in the humanities. The third one, Chicago style, is a citation protocol established by the University of Chicago. Chicago style is also used in the discipline of the humanities, social sciences, religion, and so on. There are also other styles. You may choose a citation style, see, based on the discipline and fine field of research you are working in. Each citation system has its own distinct style for citing sources, both within, that is index, or at the end, that is the work cited page. The features of each style are based on the values of the field that use them. Learning the reasons for these features demonstrates a lot about particular discipline and the advantages to having different systems. The other significant benefit of your academic research is that it allows people to navigate the text and access its structure and organization better. With the standardized reference format, readers can simply check your citation by using the index ones, footnotes, or endnotes, or the bibliography present for each source. They don't have to guess or wonder where a particular quote or idea originated. It also makes the work of readers look the same in terms of format, which shows a meticulous work following the academic standards. Proper citation allows readers to return to the original idea incorporated into a research to check its appropriateness and relevance. Or it can help to access the authentic set of statistics or documents used as reference. Proper implementation of API Chicago, API, or any other relevant style sheet shows not only the reliability and reasonableness of the writing and the research, but also widen the borders of specific area and help the developing of further studies on the subject. What is the importance of this review of related literature in research writing? As far as the research methodology and the style sheet, I would like to highlight only two things today. One is research methodology supplemented with the style sheet, and another is review of literature. Because when I supervised some of the dissertations, and when I evaluated some of the dissertation as external examiner, I found that many of the students have not carried review of related literature, and many of the researchers as well as the research supervisor are not well equipped with the style sheet. That's why I have taken this topic for today's my talk. What is the importance of review of related literature in research writing? First of all, we will see what is literary review. The literary review forms the core of all research. As a scientific investigation to succeed in a new conclusions and establish facts, each research builds on existing data. A literary review is a survey of books, articles, chapters, journal papers, and other systematic research sources relevant to select topic, shape and the scope of study or the theory, to supply and outline summary and important analysis of a plan, faculty of thoughts or concept bearing on to the extent of data in their field. Once confirmed, it establishes to the readers the author's depth of understanding and data of their subject. So what is meaning of the word literature in the term review of literature? Literature refers to a collection of published information, materials, or a particular area or a research or a topic, such as books and journal articles or academic values. However, your literature review does not need to be inclusive of every article and book that has been written on that topic, because that will be too broad. Rather, it should include the key sources related to the main debates, trends, and gaps in your research area. In essence, a literary review identifies, evaluates, and synthesizes the relevant literature within a particular field of research. It illuminates how knowledge has evolved within the field, highlighting what has already been done, what is generally accepted, what is emerging, and what is the current state of thinking on the topic. In addition, within research-based text, a literary review identifies a research gap, that is, unexplored areas, and articulates how a particular research project addresses this gap. Now, what is meant by the term review here in the review of literature? To review the literature means to be able to identify first what has been established, discredited, and accepted in your field that you are going to explore, that you are going to select. Areas of controversy or the conflict among different schools of thoughts, problems or issues that remain unsolved, emerging trends and new approaches, and how your research extends, builds upon, and departs from previous research. A review of literature presents such more than a summary of relevant sources. The act of reviewing involves evaluating individual sources as well as synthesizing these sources in order to gain a broad view of the field. At this field level, a literary review discusses common and emerging approaches, notable patterns and trends, areas of conflict and controversies, and gaps within the relevant literature. When you can clearly observe these things, you will be able to locate your own research and contribute to ongoing debates within the field. Now, what is not a literary review? Let us say, it is very important to note that a literary review should not be simply a description of what others have published in the form of a set of summaries, but should take the form of critical discussion, showing insight and an awareness of differing arguments, theories, and approaches. It should be an analysis of the relevant published work linked at all times to your own purpose and rationale. A literary review is not simply a chronological catalog of all your sources, but an evaluation of the same. It pulls the previous research together and explains how it connects to the research proposed by the current paper or the topic. All sides of an argument must be clearly explained to avoid bias, and areas of agreement and disagreement should be highlighted. A literary review is likewise not a collection of quotes and paraphrasing from other sources. A good literary review should critically evaluate the quality of findings of research. Now, what is the purpose of literary review? The literary review provides foundation of knowledge on topic. The literary review identifies areas of prior scholarship to prevent duplication and give credit to other researchers. A literary review identifies inconsistency, gap in research, conflict with previous study, open questions left from the other research. A literary review identifies need for additional research and justify the same. Literary review identifies the relationship of works in context of its contribution to the topic and to other works. Literary review place your own research within the context of existing literature, making a case for why further study is needed. What is the importance of literary review? A literary review serves various purposes, as it gets proper understanding of the problem chosen. It provides a theoretical background for the research. It broadens the researcher's knowledge base and brings clarity and focus to the research problem. It helps to establish the links between what is proposed to be researched and what has already been studied. It enables the researcher to show how his findings contribute to the existing body of the knowledge, and therefore helps to contextualize the research findings. It is not a comprehensive history of your topic, but a way to provide context to your reader about research that has preceded your study. It sharpens the problem, reformulates it, or even leads to defining other closely related problems. It shows how the problem under study relates to the previous research studies, and it notes whether the proposed problem has already been solved. Thus, a clear line between previous studies and that have been carried out and the research to be undertaken must be shown. In short, the proposed research should be the point of departure from the existing knowledge, that is, what the proposed research will do that is different from what has been done before must be demonstrated. The literary users clarifying the extension of data requires area that need more investigation and then it as a start line for future analysis. Now, how to write this literary review? After defining a problem, the researcher has to do literary survey connected with the problem. Literature survey is a collection of research publication, books, and other documents related to the defined problem. It is very essential to know whether the defined problem has already been explored or not. Status of the problem, techniques that are useful to investigate the problem and other related details. Review of the literature in the area of research is a primary step before attempting to plan the study. A literary review in any field is essential as it offers a comprehensive overview and recapitulates on the given scholarship from past to present, giving the reader a sense of focus as to which direction your new research is headed. A review of related literature can be written through 5 steps. First, search of relevant literature. Second, evaluation of the sources. Third, to identify themes, debates, and the gaps. Fourth, outline the structure. And the fifth, first, to write your literary review. A good literary review doesn't just summarize sources, but it analyzes and critically evaluates to give a clear picture of the state of knowledge on the topic or selected by you or your subject or discipline. This is what I had to say. Thank you. Thanks to organizing team for giving me an opportunity to be here in this August gathering of intellectuals and making a talk on the two most important ingredients of research. The first one, research methodology supplemented with style sheets, and the second, review of related literature, which is not being taken seriously by research scholars as well supervisors in doctoral research. I hope this talk will help them to understand the same. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Irvin Nawale, sir, for devoting your precious time and enduring this. Dr. Suma, ma'am, over to you.
Thank you, Supriya.